Hello, mushroom lovers. It's the day I'm spawning a batch, and someone thought that this was my first batch I've ever done. They were like congratulating me, and it's not my first batch. Not that I've done like hundreds, but it's definitely not my first batch at all. It's just the first one that I have videoed. So, anyways, if you want to see how I spawn bags, just keep on watching. To actually spawn my bags. So videos one and two, I mixed my substrate, bagged it, put it in my steam sterilizer, sterilized it for a day, call it, let it cool down in the sterilizer for a day, then outside of the sterilizer on racks for like 2 days. It might have even been 3 days. I got a little bit busy. So I'm about to spawn. And then I'll actually let it sit on racks until they colonize. So I'm gonna put on a mask in just a minute. You don't wanna be talking while you're spawning. You don't want any contaminants, even like spitting, hair. I should probably have my hair in a net, but I do have it in a ponytail, so I won't be touching my hair or anything. But to get you caught up, number one, I'm gonna be spawning. This is, hopefully you can see everything. This is a golden oyster, and it's from North Spore. So that's at the moment where I'm getting all of my spawn from. They've been great. I used to use Aloha, and I've used Amosil before. I didn't care for Amosil. The way that it comes, it's like rock hard, this block, and you have to be able to like manipulate it. So the block is rock hard and no like breathing room, so it just didn't work for me. Although when I finally did get shrooms, they were awesome, but it was a pain. Aloha was great, but I'm in the Mid-Atlantic region, and shipping was like freaking horrible. It was so much money, so it just wasn't profitable for me to do that. North Shore is in Maine, and until my buddy TR starts really making a lot of spawn, that's who I'm using. So last thing, I'm going to do another video probably next week or later this week about kind of the business aspect. Again, you know, I'm newer to this, but I do have a lot of restaurants. I've got about 15 restaurants or so. I've got two CSAs that I'm about to start providing mushrooms for in the spring. So I do know, you know, from a business standpoint, how to get ramped up, how to get your name out there, how to get some of these chefs ordering from you, if that's the route that you want to go. And I will do a farmer's market as well. I don't know if I said that. So try to keep this as brief as possible. I'm gonna speed stuff up in editing, but what I've done so far, first thing I did, number one, fresh, clean clothes. I didn't, like, I've got animals, and I'm always talking about my animals or even my dog or whatever, but I've got goats, chickens I have to take care of. They always have to get taken care of after I've done my lab work. Even other stuff, like in the grow room, for example, I've got to harvest, I've got to add water to my, humidifiers, I've got to clean in there. I'm still doing vacuuming from extra water. All that stuff has to come after lab work. You always do your lab work first. Again, you don't want contaminants. Let me turn this camera around. You can see that I've got my Home Depot plastic fabric up, or plastic whatever up, separating this room from the room where I do the bagging and mixing and all that stuff, because you know, I don't want all that, any kind of debris coming in here. I've got two flow hoods going. These are they're 2x4 each, and I've got two of them, so they're 8x2, which gives me plenty of room to spread out. Let me back up. Sorry, it's tight quarters in here. I'm gonna show you one other thing that's actually behind me. So back here, this is the laminar flow hood. This is, you'll hear me oftentimes talk about a Gucci flow hood. This is the one from Fungi Perfecti, and it really is awesome. It really is kicking out HEPA, you know, filtered air, like really, really good. But it's just not big enough. It's like, I think it's like 1x2. So, I mean, when I was like doing lab work, I'm like, you know, little hands kind of situation, or little arms. So that didn't work. So that's why I got the bigger ones. And but I have them both on. There's, you know, if you've got them, put them all on so that the air is as scrubbed as possible. I love Paul Stamets. Not that he'd ever watch this channel ever, but in case he did, peace out to you, brother. You know, I love you. But I gotta be practical. One last thing that Paul Stamets says not to do, and I'm sure everyone's read his Bibles. I'll show you. He says not to have a trash can in the lab. Completely agree with him, except for I completely disagree. I understand why he's saying it. You know, again, you don't want contaminants and all that stuff. So what I've done, this trash can, it's the same one actually that I've taken to my grill. So what I've done, I've washed it. Whenever I come in here, which is, you know, once a week, because that's not a story. Whenever I'm in here, I wash it with just Dawn. And then I have a new liner in here. So it's a fresh liner. And you'll see a napkin in here or a paper towel. The reason I keep it in here is because as I'm working throughout the time, I will re-sanitize with alcohol or something just to make sure that things really are as clean as possible. And I have to have a place to throw those. And I can either throw them on the ground or throw them in a trash can. So it's like, duh, for me. Unless I'm missing something, someone can definitely let me know if I'm missing something. But I will, just like Paul says, I will take this out of this room once I'm done with it. I'm not just going to leave it in here. And sorry, I've got this light here. Let me move this light. Yeah, so that's kind of annoying. It's not very bright, so I have that light in here. Okay, so I'm about to start. So again, what I've done that you haven't seen, I have sprayed down my table with this. It's like Pledge Multi-Surface, and it actually is 99%. You know what? This is hilarious, because I could have sworn. I'm so glad I'm looking at this. Now, this talk about it. Okay, this is hilarious. Maybe there's another one that I have. Shoot, I don't see it. So another one that I have actually has, like, it's like 99% like antibacterial. This one is not. This is a new one. So make sure that whatever you're using on the table is antibacterial. So I gotta go get the other one, my old one. But anyway, so I did do that. I wiped down everything, but I am gonna go back over it with my isopropyl, which I use this here instead of the like the big, you know, the big jar or not jar instead of this thing because I feel like it gets everywhere. It's not like extremely portable. At least for me, I'm a klutz. So after I go, I'm gonna get the right cleaner. I'm gonna wipe everything down again. Put some isopropyl, really work it in with some paper towels, throw the paper towels in that trash can. I'm gonna use this cup. This cup has been washed with Dawn and sterilized again with isopropyl, or it's been rubbed down with isopropyl. Someone told me, I can't remember who, that I should put this in the steamer with like the bags to get it really sterilized. I haven't done that. I didn't do it. It can't hurt to do it. I'm guessing. I mean, I'm sure it can never hurt to have things over clean. I didn't do it. I've never had a problem yet, but I just forgot, honestly. So, you know, if you're doing it, try to, you know, remember to put something like this in. Other people don't even use a cup. They just kind of go by the look. I've been using a cup, about 3/4 of a cup per bag. That's for my batch. I'm doing about 24 bags. And that math just works out approximately for me. I always have like a little bit extra, but and that's for a 6-pound bag of spawned. Again, like I'm using 10-pound bags, so my substrate is 10 pounds. So, last things we're gonna need I just have a disposable razor blade. You know, I have both, but I'm just using a disposable. It's sterilized already. A dust mask. You don't need the big old HEPA mask like you do in the grow room. You just need something, again, to catch any particles that are coming from your mouth or whatever. Since I'm gonna probably be doing some talking, I'm putting the mask on. If you're by yourself, you might not have to do it as long as you're not talking and stuff, but I'd rather just do it anyways, especially if you cough or have the flu, but you shouldn't be doing that. Got my spawn. I'm gonna rub it down really good with alcohol, with isopropyl, again, with the paper towels. I might have already said that. And then the last thing, this is a 16-inch, what is it called? 16-inch, oh my God, what is it called? You guys are so laughing at me. Sealer, what is that sealer called? Impulse Sealer. Oh my god. Literally the freaking name is right here. I'm bad with like memory, but Impulse Sealer. So 16 inch, and it's big. I actually got this tip from Eric. Most people are, or at least he used to use like a 12 inch, but you gotta use the gussets. You gotta get the gussets right. With this one, you don't have to worry about the gussets. You just put the whole, like, you know, just put the bag in flat and seal it. It's automatic, so I can come back to it and it does it fine. So, all right, I've done enough talking. I'm gonna turn this off. I'm gonna go find the appropriate cleaner for the table, clean that one more time, and then I'll just get started. And I'll do like 3 blocks to show you how I do it, and then I'll cut so that I can do the rest of them. So, all right, stay tuned just for a minute. Okay, just so you all know that I'm not BSing, here is the Pledge multi-surface with the antibacterial. It's kills 99.9% of germs, whereas this one did not. I just bought this one this week, so I guess you gotta make sure that you got the right shit, right? Because that could be bad. So, all right, I'm gonna go ahead, put my mask on and all that, wipe everything down, and then I'll get started. Now, one thing you notice that I just did, I had to spray. There's 2 ways you could do it. You could either spray, well, I guess I don't need this just yet. You could spray, you know, just directly on the surface, which is what I did, but I made sure that the angle was pointed away from the flow hoods, because obviously you don't want like sprays or anything like that to get into the flow hood. So I sprayed it away. Probably the safer thing to do was to actually spray the paper towel, but I've done it enough to know I'm comfortable with what I do. And it blows outward, the air, so if I'm pointing it away, the air is blowing out, it should go this direction. Okay, again, so that's done. I'm just gonna take my isopropyl one last time. I'm gonna clean the table just like I just did with the antibacterial stuff. And then the last thing before I actually start is I'm going to isopropyl my hands on top of my nitrile gloves. And this again, this is why I'm saying I keep a trash can, because I've already used like 3 paper towels, you know, again with cleaner, but I haven't, you know, 3 paper towels and I haven't even gotten started yet. So one last thing, I'm going to use the isopropyl. I'm actually going to use it on the Impulse Sealer as well. Everywhere that I have to touch, the handle, the top, the sides. And while I'm on the subject of the Impulse Sealer, there are 2 settings on here. There's a heating setting and a cooling. I have mine set to 6 for the heating and 4 for the cooling. You know, it's going to depend. You're going to have to mess around with it, whatever type bags you have, because every bag is different. I'm using, these bags are the, I can't remember if these are the Unicorn XLA bags or if they're Fungi Perfecti bags. I did have a couple of Fungi Perfecti bags. I stopped using them because they're not as big as the Unicorn bags. So that's what I'm using them for. But anyway, so just wipe all this down. My point is the material might be, you know, more thick on one bag than another. The last thing I'm going to isopropyl is the spawn bag. So you want to use the isopropyl everywhere, all over, and then especially in the cracks where you're going to open it. So I'll show you. So like in here in the gussets, you want to get as high up into the gussets as you can, because that's where you're going to actually you know, make your cut. So you want it really good, especially there. All right, last thing before I put my mask on and start this whole situation with I'll use this again, with this measuring cup. some people, that's what they do. Other people, I'm sure, are going to be like, no, you're introducing contaminants if you use this, especially if you're getting your hand kind of in there. I've been trying to cut kind of as low as I can so that my arm and my arm hair and all that aren't in there. But again, that's why I washed all the way up to my elbows, like really, really good. And then I used Purell all the way up to my elbows in case my arm does kind of get in there. I haven't seen any issues with it. It's more efficient for me to like I said, get that right amount in there and to do the process as quick as I can. Which getting your spawn in the bag quickly and getting that bag sealed up quickly, that's half the battle right there. If you have your bag like open for freaking 5 minutes, I mean, it's that much easier for contaminants and bacteria to get in it. So spawn it quickly, and then spawn it, close it, done, as quick as you can. All right, so I'm gonna get my bags and we'll get started here. One more time for the hands. A little bit on my arms. All right. So I'm gonna put a couple of bags in here. Let me see, make sure you can see this. You know what, I'm not even cool. There we go. All right, I'm gonna put 3 bags in here. Well, I'll just do 2. I mean, 2 is enough. So I'm gonna take my, where we go? I'm gonna take my scalpel. Yeah. Trash can. And again, this is already sterilized, but I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna cut across to open the bag up fully. Now I'm trying to keep the bag as close to the laminar, or not the laminar, but the flow hood as possible. You can also buy like measuring scoops that have long handles, which is probably better. And I probably will do that, but I haven't yet. I just have, you know, a regular standard measuring cup. All right, so I'm gonna put that down. And I try to do things in pairs. So I'm gonna open this up, kind of pull on the gussets like that, kind of. And kind of make a little bit of an opening. And I'm gonna do this on both of them. So you can kind of make a little bit of an assembly line. All right, so now I'm gonna take my spawn bag, which, all right, here's a lesson learned, here's a mistake, because I was talking. This is a little bit half down. Kind of like the Amosil, but not quite as bad. It makes me still see me. It's not quite as bad, but you want to break up your spawn as best as you can before you open it. So if I had been like not talking to you guys, I would have kind of gently rolled it and stuff to kind of break up this spawn a little bit so you can more easily get some out. But this is another reason why I really like using a measuring cup. Because if you had to break it up, you know, sometimes it does come a little packed like this. It's harder for you, at least it's harder for me, to pour it out. So a traditional way of doing it would be to take this bag. Now, it wouldn't be all the way closed. You would just open it a little bit from here, and you would then pour it into the direction of the flow hood without touching this bag to this bag, not touching anything. But I'm not doing that. So I'm gonna fill about 3/4 way full with this to about here, straight into here. 3/4 of the way full, straight in here. And mine is definitely a little bit messy. I always have a lot of spawn on the ground when I'm done, which I'm guessing is normal, but All right, so I'm getting ready to seal it. And what I do, so I've got it closed right now, to, you know, try to limit how much air is in there. That one has air in it, or it's open, but I've got it near the hood. So I'm just kind of, you notice I'm kind of pressing down a little bit with my arm. It just makes it easier when I go to shake the bag. So one last thing, the easiest way to shake the bag is you got to have air in it. So you want to kind of open it up, get a little bit of air in there, and then close it quick. And then go ahead and do the sealer. So make it nice and tight when you're about to seal, because if you don't, it's going to create these like little ridges, and I'm just going to close that a little bit. It'll make these little ridges, and it's more likely that it's not going to give a good seal. All right, so this should be sealed. What you want to do is take the bag and kind of press the air down to see if there's any air leak. If there is, reseal it. And you can kind of look to see where it's sealed. This one is good. So I'm going to set this aside, and I'm going to do this one. So again, I'm going to set it down. And I have it as closed as I can just for right now. And I kind of take, and then you want to do this gently. You don't want to obviously rip the damn bag. So just kind of do that. I quickly kind of try to open it up a little bit, get some air in, shut it quickly again, line it up. And some people are way faster. Not some, a lot of people are way faster. I'm like, I'd rather do this and get it done the right way. And every time you do it, you'll get more and more comfortable, obviously. So again, do the test. This one's good. So now it is time to shake the bags. So normally I do 4 to 5 bags at a time, let them pile up, and then I shake. But I'm just doing 2 bags to show you. So the reason I kind of press down like that is because now you got to shake up the bag. You got to break up these points, not only within the spawn, but also within the actual substrate. Now this bag is a great example, all right? I can already tell that bag is going to be better, but the whole point of what I was saying, that you need to add some air into your bags, it makes it so it's easier for you to shake. Okay, and like spread all this spawn out. Because if you don't have enough air, you can't really shake it. This, I mean, it has some air, but not as much as I like. So, you know, what I might notice, if I can't like get it around good enough, when it starts to colonize, it's going to colonize kind of in one spot more than another because it wasn't, you know, totally, dispersed like properly. So that's how I do that. I do this a lot to get some down, and I just do it all the way around, flip it, and shake it down. Do like that. And that's probably overkill, but that's how I do it. I had to do it a little bit like that since, again, this didn't have that much air. So the last thing I do is kind of pack it down. I want it to be a nice kind of hard block so that, you know, I don't want it all fluffy on the top, because when it goes into the grow chamber, I'm going to flip it upside down. There's a lot of different ways of doing it. You can flip it upside down. You can put it on its side. My friend TR taught me how to flip it on its side and do a cut a certain way. So bottom line, I want it flat on this top, and I want a nice solid block. You know, not something that's like that, you know, and lots of fluffy air on top. Nice and firm. And that's it. So it's going to go back. My right behind me, right here, is my my rack. The same rack that I used to cool everything off is the rack that it's going back on to then incubate for however many weeks it takes. So I hope this was helpful. I'm going to keep up with the next, you know, however many bags, and that's pretty much it. Again, going on the shelf, and then that's pretty much it. Once you have it spawned and closed, it's good. It's good to go. So thanks so much for watching. If you found it helpful, be sure to like the video, subscribe, because I am going to do another part in the series, hopefully if I remember, And actually, I might just do it with the previous batch and just kind of maybe do it this week. But I'll show you again once what it should look like when it's fully colonized and what to do with it when it goes into the grow room. So if you want to see that, make sure you subscribe, and I'll keep having at least one video a week. That was my New Year's Eve goal, and or my New Year's goal resolution, and I think I've been doing about two. So anyways, take care, be safe, have fun, drink some wine. I know I will. Take care. Thanks.